Hello gamers around the world, I'm Spiracus. Welcome back to Game Breaking News, the show where you can get everything important that happened in the world of gaming. I have been on vacation for the last couple of days, but I am right back in time for E3. So, over the next couple of days, I will put out a bunch of videos where I will summarize each and every E3 press conference and also all the important news we get during E3 itself. And to start off the convention, a pre-event was already held by EA, which is basically their press conference. And, well, what can I say? It was... I don't want to say disappointing, yet another word doesn't really come to mind to describe it. Sure, they showed us more about the upcoming Star Wars Battlefront 2 in the end, but that was really the highlight of the show, and to be honest, it wasn't too impressive or surprising. But first things first, they started the show with a pretty well-made trailer for the new story mode for Madden 18 called The Long Shot. And I've got to be honest with you guys, I was kind of impressed by it. It really, really looked like a movie. And this is clearly what they was going for. What really came to mind was The Blind Side with Sandra Bullock. And they probably want to go a similar approach like with Alex Hunter in FIFA 17. But I will get to that in a moment. In Madden, though, they seem to want to focus more on the story itself than just the framework of the story. So yeah, this new story mode has quite the potential to become a real deep story to tell about the struggles of a young man who tries to become a pro in football, but probably in the end it won't be. At least not in Madden 18 this year. Next on the show floor was Battlefield 1 and its new upcoming DLC In the Name of the Tsar. The about 5-minute presentation, you can summarize it with, well, Battlefield 1 still looks amazing, also with the new night medals that are coming as well as the new maps on the Eastern Front with the DLC. And that's already it. Next was FIFA. So, after jerking off to the incredible success of the FIFA franchise in esports and announcing that they want to focus more on real-life tournaments with FIFA games in the future, they finally got some actual FIFA 18 content. Or did they? Because they didn't really, to be honest. They put out the Men in Blazers, some duo that reports on the Premier League in the US in weekly podcasts. And they were just praising Ronaldo, who is the new face of the game, and that they were analyzing his moves with a new technique and blah, 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 bloops. Nobody really cares about, and basically the game didn't really advance at all. Alright, after that, they also started to talk about Alex Hunter, who was introduced last year in FIFA 17 with the new story mode, The Journey. And it will continue this year with the story mode called The Journey Hunter Returns. Last time, Alex Hunter wanted to rise from the little nobody that he was to the star of the Premier League. And this year, it is to start as the star of the Premier League to become the greatest footballer on earth or something like that. So, the next moment was quite ridiculous. They started to show off Need for Speed Payback, and they used a YouTuber to do that. And this guy made sure that we know that he is a YouTube creator. That is why he repeated that again, to make sure that we know that he is on YouTube, instead of really presenting the game, because I think he forgot his text. Twice, actually. Seriously, the Men in Blazers were not that great in my opinion, but they were still on topic. But that guy was an outright stupid choice, and he doesn't even play games on his channel. He's just one of those successful YouTube bullshitters. Alright, whatever. After some useless talk, we actually got some gameplay presentation of the game, and, well, some information about the game was already announced a couple of days before E3, and now we basically know it all. So, we play as three characters who team up to fight a cartel called The House, in a city called Fortune City, which is basically Las Vegas. This cartel owns the casinos, the criminals, and the cops of the city, and you want to take revenge on them for some reason. Or should I say, you want to pay back? Anyways, the gameplay presentation reminded me of three things, and these are probably the three things they were going for. First, the kind of mission that they showed us, where you got to take out some criminals and change a surprisingly fast and agile truck, reminded me very much of Need for Speed The Run, which in general was not really well received by critics and gamers alike, and if I recall correctly, it did not really have that great sales numbers as well. But personally, I liked The Run, you know, in a pay $2 to $5 for it and then play it for a weekend kind of way. Second, the whole gameplay presentation had a really, really, really strong Fast and the Furious vibe. So I guess we can expect this game to become some action fuckfest with explosions and flying cars and invincible characters where nothing has ever any consequences. It doesn't matter what they're doing, there are no consequences whatsoever. And third, GTA 5, because we have three characters that we can either switch around all the time or in between missions or something. And also we have an open world to play with, but still tuning like in the other Need for Speed titles is still there in the game as well. So to sum up this Need for Speed, Payback will be some sort of playable Fast and the Furious game with more action porn than a Transformers movie. I mean, sure, this still can turn out quite entertaining, but if you expect something like the good old Most Wanted or the Underground games, well, forget about it this time. Alright, after the awful presentation with that stupid YouTuber, they started to talk about EA Originals and how EA is so great and supporting independent studios, and yeah, I'm also Mother Teresa. Anyways, Joseph Fares enters the stage, and just like last year with the presentation of Unravel, we have once again a indie director and also writer where you can really feel their love and passion for the game they create. But unlike last year, Joseph Fares was not a trembling tweet on stage. No, he was actually kind of a cocky motherfucker, but still managed to stay quite sympathetic and likable. He was already the director for the game called Brothers: A Tale of Two Sons. And afterwards he created a new studio and started to work on a new game that he also announced on stage called A Way Out. Like in Brothers, you control two characters, but it's different in this game. This is a pure split-screen co-op only game, at least that's how he described it. So you play as two guys who meet in prison and they want to get out. And also you play afterwards, so it's not just like a prison break story, but there will also some things happen outside and we get to see that shit as well. I mean, this seems like a really great story and also a really great way to play it, that story. But to be honest, I think that sooner or later the idea of this game being a solely co-op game and that you can only play it split screen with a buddy on the couch, this is how Joseph Fares wants it to be. Well, I'm pretty sure that that will change even before the game releases or shortly after the game releases with a patch or something like that. So you can play it alone or online with a friend and nobody else has to sit on the couch with you. That's because I think that's what EA is going to do at some point. But seriously, the game looks great and also the way you have to play it in split screen, that really seems like a really great and fun thing in my opinion. Next up was a little glimpse of the new IP from BioWare that is called Anthem, but they didn't really show anything and referred that more will be shown at the Microsoft Media Brief the next day, so they can also show off the great capabilities of the new Xbox Scorpio. So I guess we'll wait for that. Now, after a brief look at NBA Live and the new story mode there called The One, which is basically just like in Madden and FIFA, it's only its own form, they moved over to the highlight and the grand finale of the show, Star Wars Battlefront 2. And they showed off the real-life actress for Aiden Versio, the protagonist in the story of the campaign in Battlefront 2. And after Joseph, she was the other likable presenter on stage, next to all those fake enthusiasts and stupid YouTubers. She was some hot stuff as well, to be honest. But there was basically nothing new about the story itself on the show. Aiden Versio is some store pooper and the story takes place somewhere between episodes 6 and 7. But they finally showed off the multiplayer and some of the new changes. The probably biggest changes are the new class systems, where you have to choose either the heavy class or the assault class or the captain's class for support, for example. And then you also are fixed on those weapons and special abilities and whatnots that come with that class. Which is, I think, a good change to the game because it felt kind of the same all the time playing Battlefront 1. It didn't matter what kind of weapons or equipment you had. And the other big change was that those pickups in Battlefront 1, where you can gain power-ups and to start to play as a pilot or as a hero, well, in Battlefront 2, they are replaced with battle points that you can earn for playing the objectives, kills, and all that. And then spend those points to become a pilot, a tank driver, or a hero. Which is the better system in my opinion. Also, they announced that in the multiplayer, characters, technology, and whatnot will come from every era of the Star Wars franchise. From Han Solo, to Yoda, to Finn, to Captain Phasma. But the biggest question remains, Will Jar Jar Binks be a hero? And will he be the most useless hero ever made? And finally, they announced that Battlefront 2 will get all its DLCs and maps and whatnots for free after the game releases. So it was already known that there won't be a season pass, that all the content is free. That is quite new. And it will be interesting to see how EA plans to replace this source of income. I for one appreciate that EA tries to find new ways to do that, but hopefully it will be for the better for both gamers and publishers and developers alike. And so they barely noticeable ended the event. Seriously, I didn't really notice that they ended it. Only after some time when they started to show off Star Wars Galaxy of Heroes, which is a mobile game, and I was like, no, just no. Anyway, the EA presentation was, well, let's say solid, but nothing really more. And EA doesn't really want to risk too much at the moment. They're doing fairly or really, really well actually at the moment, especially with Star Wars and all the FIFA and Madden games. And they just don't want to put some money into the development of a AAA title that may become a huge cost. Anthem, the new BioWare IP, is the exception. And the no-pay DLC for Star Wars is, well, still a safe option because Battlefront 2 will sell like hotcakes no matter what. So in my opinion stands, I am a bit disappointed in the show. It was solid in the way that they showed what was expected, but with the exception of A Way Out, there were no surprises or real wow factors in the show. Not even in the Battlefront 2 multiplayer presentation that sure looked cool and really Star Wars-like, but it was solid. We did not get any Switch titles or any mention of it in any ways. There was a huge lack of new IPs. And where the hell is the Star Wars game that is developed by Visceral Games? Oh well. Overall, a pretty forgettable presentation, and hopefully the next press conferences will deliver some more unforgettable moments. So that's it for now. What do you think about this EA Play event? Your thoughts in the comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Also, if you would press that like button down below or subscribe to this channel, that would be really great. Don't forget to check out my other E3 press conference summaries on my channel or in the description. I will update the links there as soon as I upload those videos. See you there.